Hey guys, what up? In this video, we're gonna go ahead and talk about the Samsung Galaxy S3 and why it sucks. Now, I don't hate this device, okay? But I made a video talking about the bad things with the HTC One X. I made a video called like HTC One X why it sucks, and I was focusing on a major software issue in that video. So I want to kind of do the same thing here with the Galaxy S3. Really try to go deep here to see what really do sucks with this device and the things that I really do hate about the Samsung Galaxy S3. And I mean, this is my new main smartphone. Okay, I went from the Galaxy Note, massive Galaxy Note, to this Samsung Galaxy S3. But I mean, I'm a reviewer, okay? So I'm not just gonna talk good about the phone. I'm gonna really try to see if I can find the issues with this phone. So I've been writing down a list here on my iPhone 4S about the things I don't really like about this device and why you may not want to pick it up, okay? Don't get me wrong. I mean, this is still a massive device. Okay, it's awesome. But in this video, we're only gonna talk about the bad things. Okay, so let's go ahead and start off with the main problem people have with this phone, and that is how it feels and it looks. So as you do know, this Galaxy phone is used in plastic. It's using polycarbonate, same as the HTC One X, but it's having used hyperglaze technology over the phone. So the kind of finish that you will get when you hold it in your hand is not going to be the same as you get on the HTC One X. Most people say that it feels like better to hold the HTC One X, and I'm going to be honest here, it feels better to hold the HTC One X like this, but the ergonomics sucks though. But that's not something I'm going to go ahead and talk about in this video. But they use this hyperglaze technology, so kind of the same finish, they get kind of the same finish as they get on the Galaxy S2. When you hold it, and also on the Galaxy Note, it has kind of the same feeling, kind of the same feeling. And I mean, me personally, I haven't heard a single person with the Galaxy S2 that's been complaining about that. But many people seem to have issue with it. But mostly, it seems like it's people that have never used a Samsung device before. But yeah, that's the main problem people have with it. So if you have a problem with plastic, you know, if you don't like that feeling, then please stay away from Samsung. If you don't like that glossy feeling, stay fucking away, okay? Now, I want to talk about something that I haven't heard that many other people talk about, and that is the up and down keys, like these, that you have on the left side of the phone. I had a few problems with them. Just 2 days after use of the Galaxy S3, it felt like they got stuck a little bit, like after you clicked on the button, it felt like it got stuck a little bit. And then I started to experiment with this. I started to feel on the Galaxy S2's up and down keys, and I gotta say, it feels like they are much, much better in build quality. They use the up and down keys. They feel much better, much more solid. Now, this could just be because I got an early unit of the Galaxy S3, or this may be a serious build issue with the Galaxy S3. I'm not sure. I haven't had any problems with the button here on the side. But overall, it feels like the Galaxy S2 and like the Galaxy Note has better build quality on the up and down keys. If you talk about the normal home button, no, not a single problem with that one. Still feels solid, just as with the Galaxy S2 and the Galaxy Note. But yeah, that's something that you may want to look into. Maybe try a friend's up and down keys to see how it feels. Because I don't think this is a major issue. But if you really want to go deep into what really can suck with this device, that could be one of the things, okay? That could be one of the things. Now, let's want to go ahead and talk about the next thing. It's going to be the AMOLED display. And I'm going to not talk about how awesome it is in vibrant colors and everything, because that's something that we already do know. But something that you may want to know, if you're going to watch a lot of movies and stuff like that, if you're going to record videos and going to be in dark environments and things like that, you may want to know something. That is that the black color could turn into blockiness sometimes when you are in dark environments, or if you watch a dark video, and sometimes it can really look awful, okay? It can really look awful. You see like small dark blocks a little bit moving around in the darkness, and I'm pretty sure how many could see this, but I could definitely see it, and it could be annoying as shit. So that if you don't want to see that shit, maybe you want to go ahead and take a look at the HTC One X Super IPS displays that can also be a lot brighter than the Galaxy S2, and it displays white colors way better than the Galaxy S2, but the Galaxy S3, I mean, of course. But the black color is much better on the Galaxy S3, but the blockiness is something a big issue with AMOLED displays, okay? So if you watch a lot of videos, maybe you should try out the video before on a friend's Galaxy S3 and really try to see if you can see this blockiness. because it can really mess shit up, okay? So I'm gonna go into the next thing here, and that's what's the camera. And I talked a little bit about it here, that sometimes when you're in dark environments, you know, you can see that when you take a lot of stuff, when you take a lot of pictures and things, when you take video with your camera, you can see that blockiness if you're in dark environments. So the camera, basically, okay, let's just be honest here. If you just take normal pictures and cool things like that, then the Sony Xperia S, if pictures really are important to you, the Sony Xperia S over here, it's the way to go. Even though it feels lagging the UI and everything, I'm not gonna lie, the camera is amazing on that device. It's like a 12 megapixel camera, even though it lags like shit like this over here, it is an amazing camera, just like that. Also, the HTC 1X is amazing if you want to take some pretty awesome pictures, you know. It has those kind of cool effects used from the default that you don't get on the Galaxy S3, and really do a great job with that. Like the camera quality on the Galaxy S3, it feels kind of the same as the Galaxy S2. I don't think even that they have like changed the sensor, so that's a little bit boring. And also one major problem with the camera that I've been seeing is that it has a hard time when you are in a lot of light. Let's say you are in a room, you have the sun just outside, you get a lot of light in your room, it is having a lot of hard time to adjust itself, the camera and everything. So when you take a lot of pictures, you can sometimes see more light than on like a Sony Xperia S and like an HTC 1X. Now, if you talk about normal video, I didn't have that major software issue that you would get on the HTC 1X International Edition, that you only got like 19 to 23 FPS. No, the FPS is amazing on the Galaxy S3. You are getting your stable like 30 FPS over there. Same with the Sony Xperia S over here, so that's very, very good, okay? That's very, very good. But in normal pictures, the HTC 1X, if it's extremely important to you, then you probably have to go with like the HTC 1X, or use a normal, you know, DSLR camera or something like that. And I mean, I gotta say that my Galaxy Note's video mode and the audio quality is when you record videos, it's amazing. I mean, like the Galaxy S3 is not even close to the audio quality, the amazing audio quality when you take videos with the Galaxy Note. They have stuff in a massive, awesome sensor and some shit like that on the Galaxy Note, and I'm pretty sure how they did it, but it just feels amazing. And the same with the Galaxy Note, when you see the normal camera mode and move around, you don't get that lag as you get on like every single other device. Sony Xperia S, HTC 1X, Galaxy S3. The Galaxy Note is really, really stable there, and I'm so sad that the Galaxy S3 doesn't perform like as good as my Galaxy Note. But I'm still gonna make a switch to the Galaxy S3 because overall, you know, in terms of smoothness and everything, it's just amazing. And I'm not gonna talk too much about the good things in this video, because in this video we're gonna focus on what most of it sucks and things that you might wanna look up before you buy yourself a new smartphone to see if it really is something for you. Okay, so the last thing here that I wanna talk a little bit about, and just to say this pretty quick here, the things that I'm talking about in this video, they're not that major issues. I mean, I only had like one major issue on the HTC 1X, or actually two like major issues. One is that it doesn't really feel good and everything, it's bad ergonomics. But yeah, okay, so let's go ahead and talk about the last thing here, and that is the software. Okay, the new software, TouchWiz UI, looks amazing compared to earlier versions, but you still kind of get that Android 2.3 gingerbread feeling, even though it's Android 4. But no, like when you go into settings, it still look a lot like Android 2.3 gingerbread. So here they can make a ton of improvements, you just update it and everything. And also in some apps, not the phone app has been updated, the dialer here looks very, very cool and everything, but in some other apps, you also really get that, like in contacts, messaging. I don't want to show you my messaging because they're kind of private, but in those apps, you still get that kind of like Android 2.3 gingerbread feeling, and that's something that they definitely could go ahead and improve with future TouchWiz UI optimizations and updates. And also one thing that that I saw a comment about was that something that would be really cool if Samsung did with TouchWiz UI was if they made this kind of bar up here on top, if they made it transparent, it would be much better cool looking, because I think that you can make it transparent on the HTC 1X. Like, it's always dark up here on the top. If they made it transparent and, you know, made it cool to the background, so you can see a little bit green up here on the top, that would be amazing if you could customize that. But I mean, of course, this is software optimizations. This is something like, if you root your device and everything, you can easily customize this and, you know, tweak it for however you want and everything. So this was my quick points. I've probably missed something, but it feels like I got the most important things out in this video about why you may not want to pick up the Samsung Galaxy S3. I mean, it may not be something for you. even though I think that if you look at all of the good things with this phone, it's probably something for you, okay? It's amazing, okay? But I'm not gonna talk about the good things in this video because I'm a reviewer. And this video title is it's the Galaxy S3, why it sucks. So I hope you got something out of this video. I'm not sure how many people are gonna watch this video, but I know with the HTC One X, why it sucks video, it got around 200k views right now. So that's amazing. Yeah, peace out. Hey guys, what up? In this video, we're gonna go ahead and talk about the Samsung Galaxy S3 and why it sucks. Now, I don't hate this device, okay? But I made a video talking about the bad things with the HTC One X. I made a video called like HTC One X why it sucks, and I was focusing on a major software issue in that video. So I wanted to kind of do the same thing here with the Galaxy S3. Really try to go deep here to see what really do sucks with this device and the things that I really do hate about the Samsung Galaxy S3. And I mean, this is my new main smartphone, okay? I went from the Galaxy Note, massive Galaxy Note, to this Samsung Galaxy S3, but I mean, I'm a reviewer, okay? So I'm not just gonna talk good about the phone. I'm gonna really try to see if I can find the issues with this phone. So I've been writing down a list here on my iPhone 4S about the things I don't really like about this device and why you may not wanna pick it up, okay? Don't get me wrong, I mean, this is still a massive device, okay? It's awesome, but in this video, we're only gonna talk about the bad things, okay? So, let's go ahead and start off with the main problem people have with this phone, and that is how it feels and it looks. So, as you do know, this Galaxy phone is used in plastic. It's using polycarbonate, same as the HTC One X, but Samsung used hyperglaze technology over the phone, so the kind of finish that you will get when you hold it in your hand is not going to be the same as you get on the HTC One X. Most people say that it feels like better to hold the HTC One X, and I'm going to be honest here, it feels better to hold the HTC One X like this, but the ergonomics sucks though, but that's not something I'm going to go ahead and talk about in this video. But they use this hyperglaze technology, so kind of the same finish, they get kind of the same finish.